Hi everyone, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm R. Santhya, Assistant Professor, Department of Food Processing and Preservation Technology, Faculty of Engineering, Avinashlingam University for Women, Coimbatore. Introduction. Food preservation aims at preventing the microbial spoilage of food products and the growth of foodborne pathogens. Thus, the two principal goals of food preservation methods are increasing the shelf life of the food and ensuring the safety for human consumption. Heat preservation is a method that uses heat to kill the microorganism or to suppress their growth and to inactivate the enzymes. Heat kills microorganisms by changing the physical and chemical properties of their proteins. There are various degrees of preservation by such as sterilization, pasteurization, canning and blanching. Blanching is an important unit operation in food processing and done as pre-treatment before freezing, canning or drying. It is also known as scalding, parboiling and pre-cooking. This technique is done for the purpose of inactivation of enzymes, modification of texture, removal of trapped air and preservation of color, flavor and nutritional value. Fruits are generally not blanched, leaving the oxidizing enzyme system active. Sometimes fruit is plunged for a given time, say 5 minutes according to variety, into water at 180 degree to 200 degree Celsius and then immediately cooled by immersion in cold water. The object is to soften the texture and so enable a greater weight to be pressed into the container without damage to the individual fruit. Blanching is usually done in case of vegetables by exposing them to boiling water or steam for 2 to 5 minutes followed by cooling. The extent of blanching varies with the food products. Sterilization and blanching. After going through this session, you will be able to understand about what is sterilization, the operations of sterilization, what is UHT treatment, advantages and disadvantages of sterilization, what is blanching, types of blanching, the principles and equipments used for blanching, then the advantages and disadvantages of blanching. Sterilization is a complete destruction of microorganism because of the resistance of certain bacterial spores to heat. This frequently means a treatment of at least 121 degrees Celsius of wet heat for 15 minutes. It also means that every particle of the food must receive this heat treatment. If a food is to be sterilized, then immersing it into a 121 degrees Celsius pressure cooker or retort for 15 minutes will not be sufficient because of relatively slow rate of heat transfer through the food in the can to the most distant point. Commercially sterile, it is a term that describes a condition that exists in the most of the can or bottle products manufactured under good manufacturing practices, procedures and methods. These products generally have a shelf life of 2 years or more. A widely used method for sterilization is the autoclave. Sometimes it is called as a converter. Autoclaves commonly use steam heated to 121 degree to 134 degree Celsius. To achieve sterility, a holding time of at least 15 minutes at 121 degree Celsius or 3 minutes at 134 degree Celsius is required. Additional sterilizing time is usually required for liquids and instruments packed in layers of the cloth as they may take longer time to reach the required temperature. Following sterilization, liquids in a pressurized autoclave must be cooled slowly to avoid boiling over when the pressure is released. Proper autoclave treatment will inactivate all fungi, bacteria, virus and also bacterial spores which can be quite resistant. It will not necessarily eliminate all prions. For prion elimination, various recommendations state 121 degree to 134 degree Celsius for 60 minutes or 134 degrees Celsius for at least 18 minutes is required. This causes the disease is inactivated relatively quickly by such sterilization procedures. For significant margin of safety, cleaning should reduce the infectivity by 4 logs and the sterilization method should reduce it to a further 5 log. To ensure the autoclaving process, it was able to cause sterilization. Most autoclaves have meters and chart that record or display pertinent information such as temperature and pressure as a function of time. Indicator tape is often placed on packages of products prior to autoclaving. A chemical in the tape will change color when the appropriate condition have been met. Some type of packaging have built-in indicators on them. Biological indication can also be used to independently confirm autoclave performance. Simple bioindicator devices are commercially available based on microbial spores. Most contain spores of the heat-resistant microbe Geobacillus stereothermophilus, among the toughest organisms for an autoclave to destroy. Typically, these devices have a self-contained liquid growth medium and a growth indicator. After autoclaving, internal glass ampoule is shattered, releasing the spores into the growth medium. The vial is then incubated at 56 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. If the autoclave destroyed the spores, the medium will remain its original color. If autoclaving was unsuccessful, the Bacillus stereothermophilus will metabolize during incubation, causing a color change during incubation. For effective sterilization, the steam needs to penetrate the autoclave load uniformly, so an autoclave must not be overcrowded, and the lids of bottles and the containers must be left ajar. Alternatively, steam penetration can be achieved by shredding the waste in some autoclave models that also render the end product unrecognizable. During the initial heating of the chamber, residual air must be removed. Indicators should be placed in the most difficult places for the steam to reach to ensure the steam actually penetrates there. For autoclaving, as for all disinfection or sterilizing methods, cleaning is critical. Extraneous biological matter or grime may shield organism from the properly intended to kill them, whether it is physical or chemical. Cleaning can also remove a large number of organism. Proper cleaning can be achieved by physical scrubbing. This should be done with detergent and warm water to get the best result. Cleaning instruments or utensils with organic matter, cool water must be used, because warm or hot water may cause organic debris to coagulate. Treatment with ultrasound or pulsed air can also be used to remove the debris. Although imperfect cooking and canning are the most common application of heat sterilization, boiling water kills the vegetative stage of all the common microbes. Roasting meat until it is well done typically completely sterilizes the surface. Since the surface is also the part of the food most likely to be contaminated by microbes, roasting usually prevents food poisoning. The common methods of cooking foods do not sterilize the food. They simply reduce the number of disease-causing microorganisms to a level that is dangerous for people with normal digestive and immune system. Pressure cooking is analogous to autoclaving and when performed correctly renders food sterile. However, some foods are notoriously difficult to sterilize with home canning equipment. So, expert recommendation should be followed for home processing to avoid food poisoning. Sterilization with moist heat. In sterilization with moist heat, temperature generally range from 110 to 130 degrees Celsius, with sterilization times being from 20 to 40 minutes. For example, canned foods are sterilized in autoclave at about 121 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. Higher temperature and shorter times may have similar effects. For example, 134 degrees Celsius for 3 minutes. However, if condition do not allow the germination of spores, lower temperature and shorter time can also be applied. For example, with acid fruit juices, jam or desserts, heating at 80 to 100 degrees Celsius for 10 minutes is normally sufficient. Then sterilization with dry heat. For killing bacterial endospores by dry heat, longer exposure times and higher temperatures are required with moist heat. Sterilization by chemical means. It can also be applied by using ethylene dioxide. It is used to sterilize the food, plastics, glassware and other equipment. Next is ultra high temperature treatment. It means a very short treatment, a temperature of approximately 140 degrees Celsius for only a few seconds is used. This results in a sterilized product with minimal heat damage to the product properties. UHT treatment is only possible in flow-through equipment. The product is thus sterilized before it is transferred to pre-sterilized containers in a sterile atmosphere. This requires the aseptic processing. There are two principal processes of UHT treatment. One is direct heating and another one is indirect heating. The first is direct heating. The product is heated by direct contact with steam of potable and culinary quality. The main advantage of direct heating is that the product is held at elevated temperature for a shorter period of time. For a heat-sensitive product like milk, this means less damage. There are two methods of direct heating. One is injection and infusion. In injection method, high-pressure steam is injected into preheated liquid by a steam injector, leading to a rapid rinse in temperature. In infusion method, the liquid product stream is pumped through a distributing nozzle into a chamber of high-pressure steam. The next is indirect heating. The heating medium and the product are not in direct contact but are separated by equipment contact surfaces. The several type of heat exchangers are applicable for this method. The first one is plate heat exchanger. This method is economical in flow space, easily inspected, and allows for potential regeneration. The next is tubular heat exchanger. It allows for high pressures, thus higher flow rates and high temperatures. The heating is more uniform but difficult to inspect. The next is cramped surface heat exchanger. The product flows through a jacketed tube which contains a heating medium and is cramped from these sides with a rotating knife. Next is double cone heat exchanger. The solid pieces are fed into the double cone. These are rotated slowly on horizontal axis with steam injection and heater surfaces. The double cone acts as a blender and coats solids. The product is discharged to an aseptic filler by overpressure with sterile air. The advantages are it is non-toxic and safe for environment. The powders, soft paraffin, glycerin can be sterilized by dry heat sterilization. It is economic. It has a short processing time. The disadvantages are it needs high heat for longer periods. The penetration of the heat takes a long time in larger devices. The materials are sensitive to high heats and moisture. The next is blanching. There are four types of blanching, namely water, steam blanching, microwave blanching, and gas blanching. In this, hot water blanching and steam blanching are most common used methods in industry, but nowadays microwave and hot gas blanching have also been used. Different hot water and steam blanchers are developed to improve its quality efficiency and to improve the processing technique with different thermal properties as well as geometries. First one is water blanching. It is a method performed in hot water at a temperature ranging from 70 degree to 100 degree Celsius. But in this type of combination of low temperature long time and high temperature have also been used. Water blanching usually results in a more uniform treatment than others. For automatic processing, different water blanchers are developed in that basically screw or chain conveyor that is used to transport the product inside the tank where hot water is filled. Water is heated indirectly with steam in the heat exchanger so that the quality of the steam does not need to be a food grade. The main disadvantages of this method is that it takes longer processing time so that it results in increased leaching of minerals and nutrients such as vitamins and also produces a large amount of effluent with larger BOD. The next is steam blanching. In this type, the product is transported by chain or screw conveyor through a chamber where a food grade steam is directly injected at 100 degrees Celsius. The steam blanching is usually used for cut and small products and it requires less time than water blanching and losses are also less. Due to temperature gradient between the surface and the center of food products, uneven blanching takes place which results in over blanched near the surface and under blanched in center. To increase the efficiency, forced convection blanchers have been developed. This technology allows higher product bed depths and higher product throughputs. To reduce the product non-uniformities, another technology is developed which is called as individual quick blanching. The next is microwave blanching. It is developed because of important findings where retention of ascorbic acid and carotene and requires a very short processing time compared to other methods. To overcome some drawbacks and disadvantages, it has been combined with water blanching. The next is gas blanching. Hot gas blanching usually a combustion of flue gases with addition of steam to increase the humidity and the product dehydration has been studied. This type of blanching has an advantage of reducing waste production and retention of nutrients. But major disadvantages of this is it results in product weight loss. This approach is currently not used in industries and need for further research. The principles and equipment used for blanching. Studies on effect of blanching as pre-treatment prior to freezing have been reviewed in late 1920s and early 1930s. Most vegetables blanched prior to freezing to inactivate the enzymes that causes development of off flavors and off colors during freezing. Some exceptions include onions, peppers and leaves because though they lose color and flavor during blanching. Gas removal is an important purpose of blanching before canning because it allows easier can fill, reduces the strain on can during heating and reduces the can corrosion. Fruits are usually not blanched or blanched under mild condition prior to freezing because blanching produces desirable textural changes. Before drying, fruits and vegetables are sometimes blanched. After blanching vegetables, these are quickly chilled by spraying cold water or by conveying them through a flume of cold water. Blowing dry air has also been used to take advantage of evaporative cooling using water adhered to the surface of the product. The first type of blanching system is a rotary hot water system, also referred as reel blancher. The product is introduced into a one component of a barrel structure and is immediately immersed in water for a specified period of time. It is then lifted from water and then removed from the compartment. By maintaining the hot water temperature at the desired level and controlling the rotation speed of the rotary mechanism, the time and the temperature exposure of the product is established and controlled. The product moves in the direction of the drum during rotation. Adjustment of the slope of the rotating drum causes the product to move from the inlet location to the exit location in a specific period of time and with the desired length of the exposure to the hot water in the lower portion of the rotary drum system. Steam blanchers usually incorporate tunnels with product conveyors. The concept involves exposing the product particles to the steam environment for a specified period of time based on the conveyor speed. Considerable attention must be given to the density of the product on the conveyor in order to maintain the exposure of the product surface area to the steam for the maximum time period. In a typical steam blanching system, product is introduced into the tunnel from a water tank inlet. In the system, the product is introduced into the water tank and a conveyor lifts the product from the water tank into the steam environment and carries the product to the opposite end where it is moving upward through the product carried on a conveyor. In this system, the movement of the steam or air mixture is sufficient to lift the product from the conveying surface in a manner that increases the efficiency of heating. A blanching concept that has gained popularity is referred to as individual quick blanching. This concept involves three distinct sections in the blanching system. The first stage, heating, utilizes either steam or water as a heating medium. A thin layer of the product on the conveyor is typically used to ensure rapid heating. In the second stage, holding, the product is held at a constant temperature in an insulator environment. During this stage, the product particles are brought into close proximity to increase the heat exchange and uniformity of temperature. After holding, the third stage of system is rapid cooling, where the product particles are separated to encourage a rapid temperature drop. In general, individual quick blanching is intended to increase the uniformity of heating of the product while reducing overheating of certain portions of the product particles. In addition, this system encourages the efficient use of heating medium and tends to produce the quality loss. The advantages of this method are it inactivates most of the plant enzyme which causes toughness, discoloration, mustiness, off flavor, softening and loss of nutritive value. It reduces the area of leafy vegetables such as spinach by shrinkage or wilting and making their package easier. It removes the tissue gases which reduces the sulfides. It reduces the number of microorganisms by as much as 99%. It enhances the green color of vegetables such as peas, broccoli and spinach. It reduces the saponin in peas. It removes the undesirable acids and astringent taste of the peel and thus improves the flavor. It removes the skin of vegetables such as beetroot and tomatoes, which helps in their peeling. The disadvantages are it is the water soluble materials like sugar and anthocyanin pigments are leached by boiling water. The fruits lose their color, flavor and sugar. This method is labor intensive. It also requires access to abundant clean water. The preserved fruits and vegetables have a lower nutritional value and generally less taste than the fresh products. However, fewer nutrients are lost using the heating method than any other preservation method. Let us sum up the whole thing. The main aim of food preservation is to reduce the microbial load in the food products, which will prevent it from spoilage. Sterilization and blanching are the two methods of food preservation. Sterilization decreases the microbial load of the food products using ultra-high temperature method. Blanching, which inactivated the various undesirable acids and enzymes using different methods of blanching, such as water blanching, steam blanching, etc.